short. Sitting in the sun, two little monkeys. Not that perfect.
Hello.
System. I wasn't far enough over. He's gonna dive, so he's getting ready to jump. Where? It's just about impossible. And figure it out, they're going to jump here and then they go somewhere else.
Don't call you Big Eight, you're spoiling my picture.
Yeah, it's off, you guys.
Get your ice cold Pepsi, Diet Pepsi, and lemonade, yeah? Right now, refill all day.
$1.49 plus tax. Well, just laying there.
Get your ice cold Pepsi, Diet Pepsi, and lemonade, yeah?
Open again.
Right now, this thing
broken.
How many?
Yeah.
One more warning to everyone standing in the blue flag area. That's right, you are in our soak zone. If you want to stay dry and protect your encounter equipment, move now before you are drenched with 55 degrees salt water. Is everyone ready to start the show?
Yeah!
Well, if you're ready, we're ready. And now, the Shamu Experience. With the rest of the trainers, we'd like to welcome you to the Shamu Experience. And what better way to experience Shamu than getting a special up-close look at him?
Great idea, Art. Well, let's start with some physical characteristics of Shamu. Shamu, are you ready? Great. Well, the most obvious is their size. Adult male killer whales typically weigh between 8,000 and 12,000 pounds, while adult females typically weigh between 3,000 and 8,000 pounds. Their black and white coloration, called disruptive coloration, helps to camouflage their actual size and shape from their prey. Shamu, why don't you give everyone a great big wave hello? Shamu is waving to you with his pectoral flippers. Those pectoral flippers help them to steer as they swim through the water. Although the flipper looks featureless, if you were to take an x-ray, the bone structure looks much like that of our human hand.
As he swims by, notice the white oval eye spot. Killer whale's eyes are located just in front of the patch near the corners of their mouth. Like all mammals, Shamu breathes air, and he does so through the blowhole located on top of his mouth. They're funny, Shamu. Their swimming power comes from their tail flukes. These large flat flukes allow them to reach incredible speeds. Of all marine mammals. Remember those tail flukes? Let's see them in action. Come on, Shamu, let's show what you got. Killer whales can reach speeds of up to 30 miles an hour.
Well, we've seen some of Shamu's unique characteristics and awesome power. But there's another side to Shamu, and that's his playful side. Over the last 40 years, we've developed a relationship with our Shamu family. This relationship is built on patience and trust. One of our favorite parts of the day is when we can get into the water to swim and play with Shamu. Thank you.
frequently asked questions we get here at Shamu Experience is how do you train a killer whale? Well, today we want to give you a behind-the-scenes look at one of our training sessions. Training sessions can vary in length of time depending on the difficulty of the behavior, and can be trained in a matter of hours to days to even months.
That's right, Art. All of our training sessions here are based on positive reinforcement, which simply means when the animal does something correct, we draw a lot of attention to that. We may give them something that they really like. What do you think killer whales really like?
Fish.
Excellent. That is one thing we know they like. They also have a variety of other rewards we can give them, such as a background, maybe jumping in the water to swim and play with them, maybe a few ice stir-fried session with our 7-year-old Sumar. So he's learning this behavior, and what it's supposed to look like is Brian is actually going to be balancing on Sumar's back and riding across the pool over towards where Robin is. Now Robin is tapping something called a target pole, and this is one of the tools that we have for training. What you can think of it as is it just an extension of our hand. Initially the animals learn to touch our hands, and we can lead them through different behaviors. Well, Sumar needs to go from point A to point B, and our hands don't stretch all the way along the pool. So what we do is we use a target pole to just kind of show them where to go. It makes it very clear for them. Now, what you can listen for is a whistle sound. This whistle, or this bridge, means that the animal just got the behavior correct. So when you hear the sound, what I want you to do is put your hands together, clap, and make a lot of noise. And this will let him know that he got it right. So right now he's going straight over to the target tap. Perfect, we heard that whistle, let's give him a hand. So as I just explained earlier, the final behavior, Brian's actually gonna be on Sumar's back during that fast swim across the pool. So what we're doing now is we're just taking a few approximations. These are baby steps towards that final behavior. So first we're just showing him go straight across the pool to the end point. And in just a moment or so, Brian will probably get into the pool and attempt this. Takes a lot of teamwork. Let's see if we can get it, everyone. So that's the signal, the three taps.
Ah!
We thank you for being part of the Shamu experience. You can visit our website at shamu.com for more information about our killer whales. Have a great day, you're on the killer whales.
Goodbye, everybody!
Sea Lion and Sea Otter Stadium. So we'll find out what's going to happen.
Sudden sprays of water that could get you wet. That is all.
Now he knows that he needs to meet me on the main deck before the captain calls for the cut. Hey, there you are, Seymour! Okay. I sure am glad to see you. We have quite a few things left here on our checkoff list, and the next thing on the list says that we need to check out the emergency blow valve. Huh, it's pretty far away. Well, Seymour, at least I know that you're a great swimmer. I heard that you were the best of your Sailors Academy swim class. You know what I need you to do? I need you to go ahead and show me what you learned. Why don't you tell me, how does everything look? Okay, good thing. That emergency blow valve is our last hope if the sub's sinking. Now hurry on back. Okay, I know. That mermaid trap freaks you out. Me too. I don't know about this plan that our so-called captain has, but it is almost time for inspection. That means that you and I, we need to head on up to the upper deck.
The world's greatest sea captain. Today, I embark on the maiden voyage of my life's work, a submarine I built with my own two hands, La Sirena.
Yes!
Today is the greatest day of all time. You didn't know that, but it is, because I, Cazador, am going to capture, wait for it, a mermaid! Yeah, a mermaid. I'm totally serious, and nothing, and I mean it, nothing, can stop me from my quest for... What now, Ruby? Right, go find my mermaid. Seriously. Eyes up here, can we? Right? Thank you. Now, what was I talking about? Yes, capture a mermaid. Nothing can stop me from my quest for this mermaid. I'm serious. That's why I have my submarine. I have my ingenious mermaid trap. That's what this is for. And I have my trusty crew. My trusty crew. They should be out here for my inspiring speech. Sam, Seymour? Hey, you out there, have you seen a sea lion whose name is Seymour? Is it the sailor named Sam? Tell me if you have seen either of them, please. Tell me out loud, actually.
Yes!
No? Interesting. Well, just scream and yell if you see them.
Yeah!
Here we are, Captain!
funny. Anyway, where have you been? You're late.
Well, Seymour and I were double checking all the systems and the mermaid trap. Everything ship shape thanks to Seymour.
Oh, fantastic. Wait a minute. Silence! Thank you. Tell me something, Sam.
Okay, buddy.
What?
Hey, check out the Pacific Ocean.
Thought it'd be bigger. Whatever. Hey, I heard that you were the best swimmer in your swim classes at the Y. Show us what you learned.
Look at you! Okay, I like it! Clyde, you are a natural. Woo! Yeah, buddy. That swimming coach taught you well. Come here. Hey, check out all the other passengers. Come on, let's take a closer look. Okay, hey, I think you found the prospect. Come here. What's your name? Christina. I like it. My name's Chris. This is my buddy Clyde. We're both on a singles cruise, and he's looking for true love. I, on the other hand, just looking for some new friends. So you and me, Lido Deck, 6 o'clock. I think she liked me. What do you think? What are you talking about? She didn't know. Ah! Start arguing with me? Oh, come on. Hey, check it out. It's Pier 6. Last one on board is a rotten sardine. Come on. Come on, buddy. Hey. Where are you? God, there you are. Whatever. Hey, check it out. I found this hat back in the engine room. I think it'll help you blend in. Look. Aye, Captain. Look, you can do it too. Now you're a Navy SEAL. What? That was awesome. What are you talking about? That was funny stuff. No, come on. Seriously.
Okay, what is it?
Behind me?
Ah!
Ah!
Hey, Captain. Captain, look, I found the stowaway.
Oh, my goodness. And one of them's on fire.
What?
Oh, no, that's just his shirt.
Oh.
Hey, shoot him out the torpedo tube.
Ah, Captain.
Either. So where's the mermaid and the pearl, huh?
I don't know.
You don't know?
It's your supper. Sorry.
It sounds like you don't even care. What are you doing?
Look over there.
Oh, look. Hello there. Hi. Hello there. My name's Casanova. Give me the pearl. Come on.
No,
do
it. Look, she wants to give it to Seymour because he saved our lives.
Seymour's over there.
Yeah.
He's swimming over there.
I know. And he's on his dramatic entrance to go pick up the pearl.
What he really said is he wanted to trade the pearl for my submarine.
That's right.
I think that sounds like a deal. You can have the sub and I can have the pearl. Hooray!
Yay, Seymour, you did it! You got your own submarine! Aye, aye, Captain Seymour!
Yes, the audience is excited! Yeah, fingers. Anyway, see you around, Captain. This pearl's gonna take me down the road to fame and fortune. Nothing can stop me now from... Whoa!
Well, how about that? Chris, you ended up with a pearl. Clyde's got his submarine. Seymour's got his submarine. And Clyde's found the love of his dreams. Everybody's happy. Aye, aye, Captain Seymour. All engines, full speed ahead. Adventure, here we go.
Have a seat on the bench right there. All right. Hey, buddy, what is your name?
Derek.
Derek, very nice to meet you. Welcome to Discovery Cove, everyone. Help me say hi to Derek on the count of three. Ready? One, two, three. All right. Derek, how old are you?
Four.
You're 4 years old. You can have a seat on the bench there right behind you. Later on in the show, Derek, you are going to get a chance to meet a very special friend of mine. Hi, and you are?
Ryan.
Ryan, it's great to have you here today. You can go ahead and step on down here, Ryan. Right over here, Ryan. There's someone we want you to meet. Here's Christy with one of our animal stars.
Hi, Ryan. Nice to meet you. You're getting the opportunity to not only meet our pilot whale Shadow, but you're one of only two people today at SeaWorld that get to touch one. So go ahead and kneel down here. Give her a nice rub on her melon. That's her forehead. What do you think she feels like?
basketball. That's a good description.
They have very soft and sensitive skin and seem to really enjoy our touch.
All right, Ryan, you can stand up. Go ahead and place your right hand near your left shoulder. Perfect. Now swing that arm down past your feet. There you go. You know what you asked her to do? Bring up those powerful tail flips, and guess what you're going to get? Where you going, Ryan? It's just a nice wave goodbye. Ladies and gentlemen, that's Ryan and Shadow.
Way to go, Ryan, for being our volunteer. We would like to present to you, on behalf of Fujifilm USA, this Fuji Quick Snap camera to help you capture all your special memories here today at SeaWorld. But right now, the trainers would like to share with you their favorite part of the day. That's right,
splash time!
Extra fun. ovation on the flag we are setting high above the show pool as we get ready to see Cindy perform one of her most spectacular behaviors. She'll be making a small jump in the corner of the pool. That's your cue to cheer her on. SeaWorld's highest jumping common dolphin.
Folks, here at Discovery Cove, this lighthouse helps to remind us of our responsibility to lead the way. Today, I've seen the Ayers family interact with our dolphin family. This is made possible as a result.
We're in the penguin place. Wow, lots of them.
I gotta see that big guy.
Oh, we're getting there. A bunch swimming here in front of us.
It smells like fish.
It smells stinky, yeah. Wow. Maybe these are from that penguin walk. We're on a floating sidewalk. I mean, not a floating, a moving sidewalk. Mm-hmm. Oh, aren't they cute?
He's just standing there posing.
I'm waving at you. Backwards.
Some of them have
flashed. Ooh, there's a little guy sitting right up here. Oh. That's really quite nice how they have it fixed up. Oh, we're getting near the end. I better stop. That guy's molting. He's all full of bears. There's a big Clydesdale team there. That looks like the Budweiser guys from Linden, Washington. Going to be coming right by us. I gotta wait for a while. There's the SeaWorld Tower. Wow, that's a long ways up. It's amazing I don't fall on my back. Maybe I should lay in the grass. I'd probably get a better view. Long ways up. But we've been around here and we've seen everything. Now we're waiting for the horses to come.
To be the preferred airline for SeaWorld San Diego and SeaWorld San Antonio. Southwest Airlines is the country's fifth largest airline in terms of domestic passengers carried, offering everyday low fares that give you the freedom to fly to more places coast to coast. Also good at pleasing air travelers, the Southwest Airlines Sky Tower soars 320 feet high and is one of San Diego's most prominent landmarks. This beautiful structure was built in 1969.
We will
be rising
there,
at 150 feet per minute, stopping at 265 feet above the ground. At that point, you will have a panoramic view of SeaWorld and beautiful San Diego.
Yeah. No. Oh, wow.
San Diego is one of America's most diverse and enjoyable
just down
cities.
There.
And 3,600-acre Mission Bay is one of San Diego's finest recreational areas.
Do you need more room?
The little island you see in the middle of the bay is the Vortex Station that provides radio communication for pilots in the San Diego area. As you look toward the Pacific Ocean, you'll see Belmont Park, where one of the original wooden roller coasters still stands. Looking down the shoreline, you'll find the Ocean Beach Pier, the longest concrete pier in the West. Sunset Cliffs and Point Loma are just beyond. La Jolla, famous for its scenic beaches and beautiful coves, is just up the coast. Mission Valley is to the east. It was in this area that Father Junipero Serra founded the first mission in California. On the hill just to the left of the valley is the University of San Diego with its splendid blue dome chapel. And directly across is the White Tower of the Serra Museum, located in Old Town.
Motels over there? That's where we stayed.
Looking toward the skyline of one of America's finest cities, you can see the Coronado Bridge spanning San Diego Bay. On the bay, you can see everything from sailboats to giant Navy ships. You can see Lindbergh International Airport, where you'll find Southwest Airlines. Off in the distance are Tijuana and Baja California. We hope you're enjoying your bird's eye view of San Diego. Thank you for taking the Sky Tower tour. If your future travel plans include air transportation, fly Southwest Airlines, the preferred airline of SeaWorld San Diego and SeaWorld San Antonio. In celebration of the long-standing partnership between SeaWorld and Southwest Airlines, we have commissioned Shamu 1 and 2, two giant Boeing 737 jets that look just like Shamu, the killer whale. Each Shamu is one whale of a plane. Look for the giant flying Shamu planes in the sky over you.
Yes, I said
we didn't have
a great day
the...
at SeaWorld.
There's the pink flamingos. We missed them today.
Yeah, we've seen them over the other part.
Yes.
Yeah,
that's where the
gate.
Are they? There's no gate right here.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. There's your bus sitting out there. The parking lot, Jim. Yes. Are you okay?
We're going down.
Well, look up, y'all. Look up. I used to tell my grandkids when they start to choke or cough or reach for the sky.
Oh, exactly. Yeah.
There's a helicopter going by over there.
I'm glad you talked me into it.
That wasn't so bad.
No, of course not.
And if it hadn't been for these people, you'd have talked me out of it, and then I would have been very angry.
John and Fran,
good.
Yeah.
John and Jeanette. Yeah. I still got a little cab of
20 feet.
Look at the dolphins, you can see them in the pool down.
Isn't that something? We met a lot of nice staff today. One girl escorted us all the way across the park.
Oh, really?
Yeah, told us the history, and she's been here for 21 years.
Wow.
Yeah. And she said the San Diego Zoo has a new owner.
Oh.
He has lots of money, and he's doing good things.
Good.
Yeah.
There's a big polar bear. We're in the Arctic. The Royal Arctic. Oh. Very nice. There's more over here.
Those teeth. Yes.
What?
No, they're on here. So.
every year. It's glorious. Giant walrus, look, he's looking right at me. Hi, sweetie pie.
Oh, Jesus.
What a perfect picture. Oh, he went a different way. There he's back again. He didn't come right close. He went sneaking in that cubby hole.
I thought he would go around, but he turned around and there he is. Gee, he's huge.
No, he came on this side, the other, right up in front of me, scared me.
Why is he upside down, the lazy part?
I don't know why he's upside down. Look at that, he came right up to the window. Wow.
Dude.
Yeah.
I think he's having fun too.
I'm gonna go down. Come on, come to Papa.
The 13th of February, we're on our bus tour to San Felipe, Baja, Mexico. We are just south of the city of San Felipe, picking up shells. They've got a really good beach here for getting sand dollars. So we've been out there in the water, you can see on the beach. Got wet feet, but we found some nice sand dollars. Here's the bus just getting ready to leave. I'm going to move down and get more of the beach. Here we are looking back north towards San Felipe. Very nice. Beautiful beaches. I think I could quite easily wake up every morning to look out at something like this. Except I'd have to move the whole family down here. Because I would miss them. There is something over there in the background. See if I can bring it in at all. It doesn't really show anything. I'm not sure what it is. People on the bus said it was something like a treasure island built on an island way out there on the other side of the Sea of Cortez, which is what we're looking at. Anyway, I think that's enough for now. It looks like the tide is already coming in, so we're lucky we only got a few wet feet. And there's the bus over there waiting for us. There's my sidekick, my shell finder helper. Yeah, we had a very nice morning. It's now just about 11 and time to head out for some more sightseeing. Beautiful place. And the gentleman put the long sleeve shirt on over there and the runners. He's our bus driver, and he took us to Laughlin 2 years ago. He had a really wild trip. And his wife is over there in the yellow shirt. She's our hostess. And that's the bus. All right, goodbye. Here we are on the top of the lookout. I'm not sure exactly what it's supposed to be. But that's out towards the rock that we took pictures of last night. There's a bus down there. Back to San Felipe.
cool there.
It's a nice restaurant down there. And there's just the beach line. Beautiful. I'm trying to spot where our place is, but it's way.
That's that orange place down there.
Yeah.
I think that's our place. Yeah, it must be.
We're back there somewhere. Orange, whatever it is. Across the bay, and this is where we are now, way up here, and there's garbage all over the place. These are the rocks down to the water. This is just leaning over the edge here and taking some more of the rocks in the water, and I can't really see too much what I'm taking, but there it is. Beautiful. Green water. Looks very nice. But it's too cold to swim in. Anyway, that's it. I think they're about to leave me, so bye. Well, here we are back at our hotel, and this is where we're staying.
El Cortez.
Yeah, El Cortez Hotel in San Felipe, BC, Mexico. And just can hear the music playing in the background. Pool is still open. The guys are working on it and cleaning it and putting down new tiles and everything. The drive we took today was way out to the tip here to the south, the direction I'm pointing. Had a nice time picking up shells and sand dollars. I'm going to walk out on the sand and show what the hotel looks like. And I go round down the hallway and around, and there's Darlene eating, and Harold's in there sleeping, and John's in there sleeping, and there's the rest of the way down the hallway. Now here I am down on the beach, and the tide is all the way in, and there's the town of San Felipe over that way, just to the north of where I'm standing. We climbed up this little tower where there's a lighthouse. And it looks like it's right up against that mountain, but there's a big bay in between. Took pictures from there. It's 110 stairs up from the road to that little tower. And this is all the way back. And this is here part of our hotel. It's a huge place, and it all faces the beach. Very nice. All the way around. This is the pool area, and there's the restaurant is down at the far end, right there where we have had a few meals, and there's a bar on the beach, and it's very nice. Huge place. And back on down the beach. A few people out there laying and getting the sun. I'm standing right on the edge of the water. As you can see, the waves coming in, wrapping the gentle little waves around my ankles. But boy, is the water ever cold. I don't think I'd want to swim in it, that's for sure. Ooh, there it comes again. That's a little bit different view. That's one of the ladies from our tour gone hiking down the beach. This is right from outside our door. I'm sitting here, Darlene and I, in the lap of luxury, looking at this beautiful scenery.
Fantabulous.
Yes, it sure is. Well, I'm trying to take this picture. It's 6:30, fall hunt time. Last night was such a beautiful full moon, and I didn't get anything. I walked down onto the beach to see what I could see. Oh, what happened there? No, it doesn't do any good to bring it in. Very strange. That's good enough. There's John over there trying to get something too. Anyway, last night was so beautiful and tonight we just goofed off and didn't get nothing. This is the hallway where our rooms are. We're upstairs. This is the bottom floor. Look at all that beautiful shiny tile and walls that are terracotta.